गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक इन द ऑनलाइन टीचिंग ऑफ साइंस। सी स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर देयर इन द चैप्टर नंबर 13, फन विथ मैग्नेट, ऑन द पेज नंबर 130, ओके 129 यस्टरडे वी हैव डन एंड टुडे वी विल कंप्लीट 130। सी, इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो यस्टरडे व्हाट वी हैव डन, एक्टिविटी नंबर 5 एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अप टू हियर। सो टुडे let me recall whatever the things we have done yesterday. So students, what we have done yesterday, that's we have attached one bar magnet over here with the help of the thread, right? And then we have marked the two points over here, isn't it? Then what we have done, what we are supposed to do, we have to just push the magnet and then we have to wait up to the magnet will remain into the rest. We have to wait up to the that much time when the magnet will come into the rest position. And lastly, we have to observe that on which direction the magnet is taking the rest, whether it's on the north side or whether in the south side, okay? So that we are supposed to do. And what we have done next thing in that, after that experiment, that activity, we have taken that magnet, bar magnet from there, and we have to attach a scale or a that thing over there. And then we have to again wooden scale or a plastic scale we have to attach there, and then again we have to push that one, and when it will stop rotating and come into the rest position, then again we have to mark the point where it is taking the rest, okay? So while doing this, we will come to know that whether the magnet is coming into the same position or not, or if we are using the scale or any other thing, it's working the same as magnet or not. So that we are supposed to do. So we will start from where we have stopped yesterday. This one, repeat this activity with an iron bar and a plastic or a wooden scale instead of a magnet that we have done yesterday, right? That instead of the bar magnet, we can use a plastic and a wooden scale instead of magnet, and then we have to check whether it's coming into the same direction or not. Do not use light object for this activity and avoid doing it where there were our current of air, means where the air is flowing, air is coming. No need to do this activity over there because the air can push the scale or this one plastic scale in the air. Okay, do this. Do the other materials also always come to the rest in the same direction? So that we have to check whether the plastic or a wooden scale is coming into the same direction for the rest, that we have to find. So let's start the next one. We find that a freely suspended bar magnet always come to the rest in the same particular direction. See what they are telling, that the freely suspended bar magnet is always coming into the same direction for the rest, which is the north south direction. Which direction is that? It can be a north south direction, any. Use the direction of the rising sun in the morning. See what they are telling, that use the direction of the rising sun in the morning to find out the rough direction towards the east. With the help of the sun, we can find out the direction of the east, okay? Where you are doing this experiment, if you stand facing east, to your left will be north. See what they are telling, that if we stand facing the east, then our left will be the north direction. Using the sun for finding the direction may not be very exact, but it will help to make out the direction north from the south. See what they are telling, that standing exact to the sun, it will not an exact direction, but it can help us to find the north and the south direction. Using the sun for finding the direction may not be very exact. Yes, that's true. It won't be very exact, but it will help to make out the directions north from the south. On your line, using this, you can figure out which end of the magnet is pointing to the north and which point to the south. See, while standing exact to the sun, we can come to know that the which point is the south and which point is the north. Okay, the end of the magnet that points towards the north is called its north seeking. It's called its north seeking end of the north pole of the magnet. Okay, the end of the north, this one north pole is consider as a north seeking pole of the magnet. द अदर एंड दैट पॉइंट्स टुवर्ड्स द साउथ इज कॉल्ड द साउथ सिकिंग एंड और द साउथ पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट. सी व्हाट दे आर टेलिंग दैट द अदर एंड ऑफ द साउथ इट कुड बी अ साउथ सिकिंग एंड और अ साउथ पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट. All magnets have two poles, whatever their shapes may be. Usually, the north and the south S poles are marked on the magnet. See what they are telling, that always whatever the magnet were having the shape, each and every shape magnets were having the two poles, north pole and the south pole. And in that magnet, it's mentioned with the north for N and south for S. Okay, this property of the magnet is very useful for us. See what they are telling, that this property of the magnet is very useful for us. For centuries, travelers have been marked using of this property of magnet to find the direction. See what they are telling, that for centuries and the travelers have been using this property of the magnet to find out the direction. Okay. It is said that in olden days, the travelers used to find the direction by suspending the natural magnet with a thread, which they always carried with them. See what they are telling, that in the olden days, what the peoples were doing, they are taking the thread and the magnet with them, and they suspend the magnet with the thread, and while doing that, they find the direction. Okay, so always they carried with them the thread and the magnet. Okay, so this compass we will do in our next video, and we will stop it over here. Okay, students, just go through the chapter, just read it, just learn it, and if it's possible, then try to do this activity at home. Okay, nothing is needed, only magnet and the thread is needed, so try to do it home. It's very simple. So the remaining portions we'll complete in our next video, and that's all for the day, students. Have a good day.